morning, guys. Officially, properly starting the vlog. Ben and I have just come out for a quick walk with Cooper. It is Monday morning. Ben's actually on like night shift at the moment, so he's at home with me in the mornings. And we really like to take Cooper on this walk. When Ben was on like the different shifts for coronavirus, he was only working 3 days a week, and so we had a lot of time together and we got into a bit of a habit of doing these walks, and it's just really nice. It's like a really nice way to start the day and like get your steps up first thing in the morning, and yeah, it's just really good to do. So as you guys saw this morning, I was on FaceTime with Casey. We are trying to make it a habit to do like a FaceTime call together on Monday mornings, kind of like a little meeting to get each other like in the mood to be productive for the week, and just like, I don't know, we get a lot of inspiration from each other and gain a lot of like productivity from talking to each other. So yeah, we're trying to make it a thing. Like 8 a.m. on Monday mornings, we're going to like connect and just like do our to-do lists for the week and stuff like that. So, and it's just a good way to catch up. So yeah, we did that first thing this morning and now we are out taking Cooper for a walk. I'm so puffed. Wow, I need to do more cardio. But yeah, the weather's so nice. So nice. I'm probably gonna have to take my jumper off soon. Oh no, Coop's getting swooped. Coop! He's got no idea what's happening. Coopy, you're getting swooped, baby. Come on. But yeah, anyways, so that's what we're doing. We're just doing like a little morning walk. And then when we get home, I really want to shoot some content for Instagram later. So I'm going to do my makeup and stuff. And swinging a bag of shit in my face. But yeah, that's about it. I'm going to try and get back into the vlogging game. My goal is to get better at it. So what better time to start than the now? It's so crazy that this is winter. I got so hot, I had to take my jumper off. It's such a nice day. This is one of Cooper's favorite parts of the walk. We just have like this massive park just near our house. It's just like literally a massive green field and he goes crazy. We always do this thing where we find a stick towards the end of the walk and we like throw it in the opposite direction and then we run towards the other end of the park, and Cooper goes and chases after the stick and then just comes flying with this stick in his mouth like trying to catch up to us. It's really cute. I think Ben's trying to find a stick at the moment. He's all the way back there. Oh my goodness. He's so quick. You're so fast. Now, which was really really nice. It's so nice to start the day with like fresh air and sunshine. And then yeah, got home and had my protein smoothie. I really like to have those after I've done exercise. That was kind of like my breakfast too. I haven't been having breakfast first thing in the morning lately. I'm just not feeling super hungry when I wake up. I think it's like the colder weather. All I want is like my warm coffee and then that's it. And then I usually just go for a walk and have breakfast when I come back. But anyways, I am about to sit down and just do my makeup while I watch the latest episode of Stephen and Desi's Fertility Journey. I am like so invested in this series. It is so amazing to see what they've been through and just like the happy ending of her being pregnant and stuff. Like, I bawled my eyes out in the episode that they announced that they were pregnant. I'm just so happy for them. Yeah, so I'm gonna watch their newest episode while I do my makeup and just have some me time. Ben is out in the garage sanding some surfboards. I don't know if you can hear the sanding noise in the background, but he's probably gonna leave for work soon as well. So yeah, that's it. That's all from me right now. Crazy. I'm trying to do like a really sun-kissed look, and I've seen a lot of people on Instagram lately doing like blush and bronzer, and they kind of like bring it up onto their like over their nose and they go really heavy with it. That's what I'm trying, and I feel like I look like a clown. Like, what is going on? Can I just not pull off this makeup style? Like, front on, I just feel like it looks really heavy. From the side, it doesn't look too bad. But I think I'm gonna try and do some like faux freckles as well. I just wanted to do something different with my makeup today. I feel like all of my Instagram posts, my makeup just looks so simple and like the same. So I just wanted to try something different. And although it's not like super crazy makeup, like it's nothing insane, I more just wanted to have a play around with that like sun-kissed look. But yeah, I'm just not sure that I'm digging it. Like, have I done it wrong? Maybe I've done it wrong. I don't know. I'm also really due for my lash infill, so I feel like my lashes are all over the place. They keep getting caught because they're like growing out and stuff, but I have my next appointment booked for Thursday, so I am getting them done again soon. I'll just have to deal with them being a bit crazy for the next few days. Oh, I just realized while I'm sitting here, guys, I may as well give you a little wedding update and let you know how things are tracking with wedding planning, but also our engagement party, because as most of you would know, we had to cancel our engagement party because of coronavirus. And now that restrictions are being lifted, we have rescheduled it for the 1st of August, I think it is. I keep getting this date confused, but I'm pretty sure it's for the 1st of August. So I'm back into planning that and getting things organized for that. Thankfully, the things that we had booked for it, we can just reschedule, and we've brought it now to the new date. So I haven't lost out any money for deposits and stuff like that, which is really great. So yeah, that's exciting. That's coming up in like 4.5 weeks. And yeah, in terms of wedding planning, so I've been doing a little bit of that over the past week and a half. I kind of went from doing nothing to then just like getting right into booking a photographer and a videographer all within the 1 week. I was getting really anxious about it because people kept asking me like, how's the wedding planning going? And I'm like, haven't really been doing much. But we've booked our venue, which we booked months ago. So we did that before all of the coronavirus stuff hit. And I'm very, very glad that we did. So that has like the date for the wedding and the venue has been booked in for a few months now. But since booking that in, I just didn't do anything else up until last week. So we now have our videographer and our photographer booked in, which is really exciting. I feel like they're two of the biggest parts of the day, like biggest expenses, and also just I wanted to make sure we could capture it and have the memories with us forever. And so that was like really important for me to book that and make sure we had all of that finalized. So yeah, that's all I've really done though. We have so much more to plan. I haven't even asked my bridesmaids yet, and Ben hasn't asked his groomsmen. Like, we're still a year out, so I feel like we still have time, but I do really want to get things like happening, just so that we know how much it's all going to cost, because it is a very expensive thing to plan and do. So the more idea we have of like how much it's going to cost, I feel like the better we'll be able to save for it and like
the more time we have to save, the better. So yeah, that's a little wedding and engagement party update. I'm hopefully going to be vlogging the engagement party and like the prep leading up to it, because I'm super excited for it, and I don't know, I really want to document all of those exciting memories. I'm really hoping that the last 6 months of 2020 are going to be like really happy and exciting, because I feel like the first 6 months have just been like, what is going on? I just want to, yeah, really soak in the next year leading up to the wedding and just create lots of fun, exciting memories for the rest of 2020. I feel like we really need to make up for what we've missed out on.
All right, so it's a little bit later in the day. I actually styled my hair today with those mermaid hair tool ones. I got mine from Mermaid Hair and I really, really like it. This is the first day I've used it and I really, really like how my hair looks. It was actually really, really easy to use. I just sectioned my hair and did it in sections, and yeah, this is the final product. Really, really happy with it. But anyways, I've just been taking some Instagram photos for the last hour. I feel like it's just one of those days where it seems to be like really difficult to get a good picture. I don't know. I'm really struggling because I really, really like my hair and my makeup today. So hopefully I can like go for round two and try and get some decent photos. It's just, yeah, I don't know. I've been taking photos on my phone, but my phone camera quality is so bad. I've got the iPhone 10 or the iPhone X, I think it's called. And I just feel like every single photo I take looks so grainy. But then if I use my camera, it just looks like, I don't know, like I'm just trying to do some cute selfies. And it's really hard to do that on my DSLR camera. So first world problems. But anyways, the reason I actually picked up my camera is because I just got a super exciting delivery. But now that I think about it, I don't think I can actually include it into this vlog. This delivery is a part of my bridesmaids' proposal gifts. So I think, as I said earlier, I haven't actually asked my bridesmaids to be bridesmaids yet. So they don't know. And I just realized if I show this on my vlog today, they're probably gonna watch this and it's gonna ruin the surprise. So that really sucks because I was so excited to show you guys. So what I might do is film in some separate clips, like me putting together my bridesmaids' gifts. I nearly gave away some info then. And I'll insert it into a vlog later on once they actually know who they all are, because I really don't want to ruin the surprise. And it's not like I can exactly say to them, don't watch this vlog, because that's also giving it away, you know? But yeah, I'm really excited about that. And now I'm really bummed that I can't show you guys, but just know that will be coming in a vlog soon enough. Anyways, that was a pointless clip then. And I'm going to go back to shooting some Instagram photos.
Good morning, guys. It is
Wednesday. It's Tuesday.
I've had a bit of a slow morning. It's just weird with Ben being on night shift because he's at home during the mornings, and so like my normal morning routine is kind of out of whack because I'm waking up with him in the bed, and because he sleeps in a little bit because he doesn't get home until late, I end up sleeping in a little bit. Like, it's so bad. It literally throws my entire routine out of whack, and I feel like I haven't even really had a routine for the last few months just with everything with coronavirus and stuff. So I kind of can't wait for it all to just go back to normal. Even though like restrictions are pretty much lifting and things are going back to normal here, it's just like Ben's work and his work shifts and timings and all of that have been so out of whack. And when he's home, I just want to spend time with him. I don't want to work. So that's what I mean by like routine going back to normal. I just want him to go back to work properly, which sounds so horrible, but I think you guys will know what I mean. But yeah, I'm currently on my way to my lash appointment. I've been getting lash extensions again. I had a massive break from them for basically the whole start of the year, and then when salons shut down because of Rona, obviously I couldn't get them done then. But now that they're all back open again, I thought, why not get them done? And I really want them done for my engagement party, which is in about 4 weeks' time, 4.5 weeks. So I figured I'd start getting them done like a month and a half before then, just so that I can get like infills and stuff in the meantime. And then yeah, I'll have them done for my engagement party. I get my lashes done at the Beauty Room in Springfield, which is in an entirely different section of Brisbane to where I live, but that's where I used to work before I moved down south and when I was still a lash technician. And I will literally never go anywhere else. So even though it's like 45 minutes away from my house, I will still drive there. I do not mind. And it's kind of nice because it forces me out of the house. I guess with what I do for work and stuff, like I spend so much time inside my house. Sometimes even just getting out and going for a drive makes the biggest difference to my mental health. So I kind of like that it's 45 minutes away because it just gives me time to like sit in the car and listen to music and I don't know. Maybe that's weird, but maybe you guys can relate. I don't know. I'm excited to get my lashes done because they look really straggly and they just fell out, not really fast, but like faster than normal. And I think it's just because the last few weeks have been kind of stressful. And if you didn't know, stress is like one of the biggest factors of like your skin, hair, nails, everything. Like it can affect it big time. And when you're stressed, your lashes will fall out faster. And I feel like that's just what's been happening. So yeah.
All right, so I just got to the salon, but I'm a little bit early. So I thought I would quickly show you guys a little before. Lots of gaps and they're pretty crazy at the moment. And this is the after.
So full, so fluffy. I'm obsessed with them. They also were kind enough and did a face mask for me. They have these new like face masks that, you know, the ones that turn to rubber. So like they go on as like a bit of the creamy liquid and then they harden as a rubber and they like peel off. So they had a new one that they just got in, which is like a coconut one, and they did that for me. And oh my gosh, they like, once it hardened, they went over it with a jade roller and it was so relaxing and so nice. And my skin feels amazing now. So yeah, I feel like I've just been pampered. I feel like myself again. So yeah, next thing is lunch because I am so hungry. It is like 2 o'clock in the afternoon and all I've eaten today are some rice cakes with avocado, tomato and cottage cheese. So I need to get myself some food and then I'm going to try and pop into TK Maxx on my way home. Okay, so I was super naughty and got McDonald's. It was literally like as soon as I turned out of the car park, McDonald's was just there and I'm just that hungry. I didn't want to have to think about what else to get. Actually, I don't know why I'm making excuses. It's McDonald's, like it'll be fine. One meal's fine, right? I got Fanta and a large Big Mac meal. I always get large because I can never finish the drinks, but I feel like that's the right amount of fries for a McDonald's meal. And because I don't eat meat, I ask for my Big Mac burgers without the meat. And so then I shove it full of fries. So if I get a large, it means that I have fries to put in the burger, but then also fries to eat on the side, you know? But yeah, that's what I'm having for lunch. Here it is. I'm not gonna do a McDonald's mukbang, don't worry guys. But I just thought I'd fill you in and let you know what I'm having for lunch because I like to keep it real. I do try and eat as healthy as possible a lot of the time, but sometimes life just calls for McDonald's and here we are. That's why I like your style. Put you in Chanel cause it's just perfect for your smile. Girl, I swear for you I run the world, I'd run the miles. Look at me, I think I'm going insane. It's crazy how we started, not to what the love you can't. You need me, say my name.